Hey everyone, my name is LC. Welcome back to another Warframe Mobile video. Now, remember in the last video, we mainly did just two missions, just showing off the new Warframe. Well, not new. Well, yeah, kind of new Warframe, and basically just showing off what Warframes I should choose for my next new videos, and also what new quests I might consider doing moving on out. So we didn't reach a final verdict yet on the new Warframe, but by the end of this video or next video, we should be able you will be able to see the new Warframe that I would have chosen and what weapons and stuff like that. So make sure you stay tuned for that new episode because it will drop sometime soon. Don't know when because I'm still kind of backed up, but it will drop sometime soon. Yes, yes I am. Always. Yes, thank you. Okay, thank you. Thank you that. But like always, I want to thank all of you guys for coming by to stop by and watch. If you're old, if you're returning, I would say without further ado, let's get into it, but like I just said it now, but like we're already into it, so technically it doesn't really matter. Who?
Target located.
Who
Bring
was
them
that?
in.
Was that the target or
We cannot let our target
okay.
know we're here. Track them down quickly.
I don't know who that was. I'm confused. But as usual, I want to thank all of you guys for coming by and watching this video and just staying in tune with my Warframe series because you guys show tremendous support when it comes to my Warframe videos. So I want to thank all of my Warframe watchers and just watchers on my channel in general. Just I want to thank all of you guys for watching. If old, returning, doesn't matter. I want to thank all of you guys for it. You deserve that. You deserve every one of it. Like you just deserve that, bro. Oh yeah, right, the new Warframe and stuff. Yeah, so that'd be the third video. The last video will be about like the junket and stuff. That's how I will lay out my videos from now on. I'm gonna do like first two videos would be about the planet and stuff like that. And then the third video will be maybe about like I think a custom video, like again, like the new Warframe or just like stuff you guys wanna see. And then the fourth one would be like the ending of the planet and stuff like that, which ending up like a certain mission. So yeah, we'll do it like that. All right, on to the next mission. Okay. Also, genuine question, and this is kind of off topic, but for those who play like COD Mobile, like just shooters and games and stuff, what are your thoughts about COD Mobile? Warzone Mobile, my bad. Yeah, what are your thoughts about that? Because here's the thing, right? I genuinely think it could do really well, right? It has the potential to be like a great for a great new addition to like mobile gaming in terms of like shooters and stuff. But, I don't know. Granted, COD Mobile lasted like a good long time, right? So there's no way like Warzone can't as well. But it's like you kind of have to question that because we said the same thing about Apex Mobile, right? And I thought it was gonna last a genuine long time because the game is it was a really good game for when it came out. But yeah, Apex was a really good game, and then. After the wait, what? Did it last 2 years or was it 1 year? I think it was a year it lasted. Yeah, I definitely think it was a year. I don't think he lasted like yeah, it was a year, but like it didn't last that long. And like, thing is, sure, the game had some like bad stuff about it, but like I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the way like the game was and everything. But and I was really good at it too. I'm not gonna lie, but. Yeah, it didn't carry on. So I was like, you gotta ask these questions because it's just one of those things where like anything could happen, right? I wonder what you guys think about Warzone Mobile. What do you think it's gonna last or not, or if it's just gonna it's a waste of time, or if things generally gonna be good? I think it can last if done correctly, right? The developers truly know what they're doing, understand like the mobile audience, then I think they could do it. I also think with Apex, I feel like they had it in the bag, like the first few months into launch. But then afterwards, they dropped the ball. I think after Rhapsody came out, that's when things kind of went like that. Yeah, like that's when things kind of just like not went to crap, but like it didn't fall through. You know what I'm saying? Like it wasn't that great. Kind of just it had no purpose afterwards. Like and that's sad. Because with games like that, like shooter games, usually they last a good while. It's like, sure they're repetitive, but there's a huge audience for that. So it's just like, what's going on? Like, I'm trying to think of the reason, like, as to why. I'm trying to think of the reason as to why the game, like, they shut down Apex Mobile. I generally don't know. Maybe I don't. Maybe it was the staffing or something, or they just couldn't like, they just couldn't get like a lot of stuff done in like the time frame that they wanted to, maybe. And like they were investing more money than like they wanted to. I mean, that's just like honestly, it's just a guess. I don't know, but like anything's possible, right? Yeah, it's sad that it ended because the game honestly it had a lot of potential, but you know what can you do, I guess. Now. As for another shooter game, I don't think it's coming out anymore. I think I heard that like they scrapped the game. But Rogue Company Mobile, that was supposed to come out too. But yeah, it's just after the beta, I think they scrapped it. And, like, I don't know what's going on with like games these days. Granted, like I know games have audiences and it's not easily always gonna be well received. But it's like they're always dropping the ball. I don't know. But if it ever came out, like if Rogue Company ever decides like they're actually gonna push out mobile, that could be a really good game too. And now, do I think it will last as long? Maybe. I'm not entirely sure. It's possible if they do things correctly. But I mean, I don't know. The only game I could see going on for a while is Warzone Mobile. Not gonna lie to you. I think the developers know what they're doing. Hopefully. I mean, unfortunately, they pushed back the release date for it until like November. But I mean, who knows? I might make gameplay on that actually. I do not like defense at all. Like I don't. It's so annoying. But if I do it now, I won't have to do it later, right? So I don't know why the topic of mobile games is just in this video. Now, like, granted, it has nothing really, like, well, kind of. Because if Warframe doesn't really understand their audience, then this game could be in trouble. But I don't think it comes to that. I think you guys know what they're doing. I quit. I quit being a game developer. I quit. I just quit, bro. Because all this hard work, look at this. This had to have taken a couple years. Like, I don't care what anyone says. Like, for example, for those Marvel fans out there, y'all remember Spider-Man Unlimited, right? Dude, that game was so good, like, back then. Like, it had a good run, man. And, like, I don't know if I remember the whole reason why they took off the App Store. I think it was because, like, the licensing or something. But it's like, a whole conversation could have just solved that problem. Like, oh, man. Like, it's sad to see, because that game was heavy. Like, it's so nostalgic. It's so nostalgic, dude. A pay-to-win game for mobile should and should not be a thing, right? Like, for them on a business side, it makes sense and makes them money. But, like, for the player, it sucks, and it's going to drive them away from the game. So, like, it's like you have to find a way.
Still working on it. Continue to defend.
You have to, like, find a good way to, like, balance the two, right? Like, find a good way to, like, let's say, I'm going to use an example. Let's say Avatar Generations, right? Game just, okay, yeah, kind of just launched, but, like, it's still birthing right now. Like, it's still fairly new, right? Advancing in that game isn't the easiest, but it's not the hardest to do. Like, I haven't spent money in that game, and I'm kept up to date. Like, I'm past every single story mission, and all that, right? But it's not easy to acquire, like, it's just getting access to certain materials you need to, like, enlighten your characters isn't the easiest. Like, you need some serious rare items, you have to grind it a lot, and the grinding process is going to be kind of grueling because it takes a while to farm up your, like, all the stuff you need. So, like, that free-to-play aspect is, like, eh, because, like, at one point you get tedious and, like, go drive your players away from the game. But they also do have, like, these paying packs where, like, you can, like, pay to get the materials you want and stuff. But, like, that's fine, but, like, That's fine to a certain extent, because, again, that's kind of pay to win, but I mean, well, it isn't, is it? Because you both have access to it, but it's just like, one person going to get access to the materials faster than the other, right? So honestly, it's kind of like meh. It's a what can you do situation. But yeah, no, locking things behind like a paywall on mobile is just, Honestly, it's death to a game. I'm not gonna lie, it's death to a game. Only game that kind of got away with it was Fortnite for a little bit. I mean, Fortnite Mobile kind of had a good run. Fortunately, Fortnite and Apple could not solve the differences. Now, that being said about mobile games, I'm just hoping that One Punch Man World is like, it takes a huge book out of like the major games that are online right now and like anime games too. Because if not done correctly, it could end up like freaking My Hero, the strongest. My Hero Academia, the strongest hero. Like, dude, when that game first came out, it was heat. Like, we were like, dude, this game has the potential to be some like a fantastic game. It was an kind of open world MHA game, right? Like, that's sick. That's in the aspect that is sick, right? But a year after this, they dropped the ball. Like, it's not a good game. I'm sorry, it's so dry. They rerun the same events over and over again. I don't think you can't convince me that. They're just done, or like do they know like what to do next, or are they just like, I think they're just, they don't know what to do next, or like they're close to shutting down the game and they're just like, you know what, let's just, you know, be one of old events until like it's done. Because, and you gotta like give credit to like the Dragon Ball games out there. Granted, Dragon Ball is like a huge IP, right? So it makes sense, but you know, it's just not right. It's just not right. Bye, yay, yay. However, I am going to wrap this video right here. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a like, comment, or subscribe. Yeah, this video kind of turned into a rant halfway. It wasn't even about Warframe at this point. I was just talking and ranting. But you guys can understand why I was ranting, because I want this game to succeed like many others, right? And I don't want it to fail like also many others. So that's why I had to get it off my chest. But yes, if you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to let me know. If you guys would like to see more Warframe content, don't be afraid to stick around and peep the channel. There's a bunch of Warframe videos you can watch and catch up on, so you can catch up, essentially. Don't forget that there will be a new Warframe video sometime soon after this. Mainly be about the new Warframe that will be chosen. And it won't be this one. It'll be, if you're the last video, you know which one it probably will be. So yeah, stick around for that. Once again, it's always a pleasure to make a video for you guys, and I'll see you all in the next video.